What's up, guys? It's Manga Time once again with Bleach 542, The Blade Is Me. Now, this is quite an interesting chapter. I have a bit of conflict as far as this chapter goes. I really, really like it, and at the same time, basically nothing happens. So, let's get down to business. It starts with Ichigo accepting that nothing that Zangetsu or Hollow Ichigo ever told him were lies, and that they all helped him in their own way. Now, we get a fair bit of interesting information, actually, on the very first page. We find out that when Ichigo was fighting Kenpachi, and he needed to learn more about his Zanpakuto, remember when he got taken in by that darkness? Apparently that was Quincy's shadow, and apparently Zangetsu used Bloot to stop Ichigo's blood. Kind of interesting, because if you read back in that fight, Kenpachi is actually like, how did you stop bleeding? I'd like to know, but I don't care. Now we do know. I like it. I don't necessarily think it's proof that Kubo has been thinking this the whole way through. It's just happy coincidence. But admittedly, it does kind of reinforce the idea that he has been planning. I definitely think that Kubo has always had the notion that Ichigo might be part Quincy. And I definitely think that Zangetsu may have often been considered his Quincy powers in Kubo's mind. So I do think we are linking things nicely together. It is coming together really nicely. Something interesting to note as far as imagery goes. Remember in the last chapter, Ichigo's, one of those buildings kind of exploded. Well, they're actually kind of being rebuilt in this one as Ichigo's feeling a little bit better about things. However, to me, this seems really odd, because Ichigo, not maybe 10 minutes ago, Ichigo was freaking the hell out that this person he'd known for a long time now had turned out to be lying to him. And now all of a sudden he's like, yeah, fine, whatever. So I thought that was kind of weird. However, it's really nice to see Ichigo kind of rise up out of the water and just be like, as far as I care, you're both Zangetsu to me. So this is like the true acceptance of his powers. So I really like that. Really symbolic beginning of the chapter. We then find Oetsu, he's like watching over the flaming, the sword in the forge. And as he does so, it reaches this certain part, and Ichigo suddenly grabs the blade. As he does so, there's a huge explosion. The sword five are like, whoa, what are you doing? But Oetsu understands. He realizes that this is the point where the sword is perfect, and Ichigo can feel that, and this is the way he wants his weapon. So Ichigo pulls Zangetsu out, and there's a huge explosion, and he seems to sort of swing it, and the water goes flying. The water all around the Hoden Palace goes flying, and it even evaporates because of the heat from the sword, and thus the sword is cooled down. Oetsu says, it basically explains all this, that your sword has now evaporated all the water in the area. Apparently they've never seen that happen before. So, and then he says, how does it feel holding these Zangetsus? And we see Ichigo's new blade. Or should I say blades, as he's dual-wielding. Yes, that's awesome. However, the design of the blades themselves, I feel, leave a little bit to be desired. They seem to be really, really basic. You have in his right hand his regular kind of kitchen knife, which is massive as usual, but really thin. It harkens back a lot more to the very first blade he pulled out of the shattered shaft, I feel. But it has like a slot in it. And in his left hand, he has a really small sword, which he holds primarily with like this kind of handle that kind of curves around like that. And the sword itself is quite short, almost like a butcher's knife. I reckon that's primarily going to be used for defense. I think as far as dual wielding goes, he's not going to be attacking with both swords. It's going to be defend with the left sword and then cut them down with the right one, which is going to be freaking awesome. I can't wait to see it. But I think I'm okay with the design of the right one. I think the left one looks really basic, though, and I hope we get a better look at them later on. Because if this is Ichigo's final weapon, it's got to look awesome. I mean, the fact that he's dual-wielding is cool, but you can't, you know, get rid of design for dual-wielding. You know, and there's no chains anymore either, which is really weird. So, yeah, this is completely new and completely weird. But I like it all the same. And so we find out that Ichigo's Hollow has manifested as the long one, and Ichigo's Quincy has manifested as the short one. Now, I think what this is to do is, because obviously Zangetsu said his Quincy power is going to take a back seat, Ichigo accepting Zangetsu as both the old man and the hollow, and the way he grabbed his sword almost before it was finished, implies to me that he was originally not going to have this small one, but the small one, I'm sorry, hay fever is absolutely killing me, but the small one came about by Ichigo prematurely stopping the forging because he wanted old man Zangetsu to be there as well. So, I mean, the fact that the left one is smaller anyway is a symbol of the Quincy powers taking a back seat. What does this mean, though, for Ichigo's, like, skills later on? Well, I mean, I've seen a lot of theories on the forums. The fact that the two blades appear to be able to slot into each other may imply that they can form a bow. That would be interesting if Ichigo could suddenly fight long range as well as short range. I also hope that he has more abilities and gets the Gotensho on the way. And I don't think he'll learn them from Uetsu, necessarily. I hope he doesn't, because I'm kind of sick of Uetsu and I want to move on from him now. But, yeah, really great. I mean, I'm really excited this dual wielding. You know, I'm really excited for what that brings. Maybe Ichigo will have a little training session with Shunsui and Okitake. That'd be freaking cool. That'd be really cool. But honestly, from what we get at the end of the chapter, I don't think there's time for that. Basically, Ichigo completely accepts the two of them. You get this really cool picture where the swords are disappearing. No idea why the hell that's happening. We're really left with not much explanation. I presume that the two blades are his Shikai, and I really hope they, like, seal into one blade, kind of Ukitake style. And he has a release command and all this sort of thing now. A lot of people have theorized his Bankai will fuse into one blade as well. That'd be awesome. Yeah, so basically we get this really cool picture where Hollow Ichigo is standing above him and Zangetsu standing above him, and he's like, "Oh, thanks a lot, guys. I'm not going to rely on you. I'm not going to push you away. I'm going to fight on my own because you are me. We're one." This is complete and utter acceptance of his powers, dominance of his powers. Ichigo is in his most powerful state, technically. Whether he's as powerful as his Dangai form, I don't know, but he's certainly in the most stable state he's ever been. However, we then get to the part of the chapter that I'm extremely excited about, and that's purely because I absolutely adore the Vandenreich. We return to the Ice Palace, and you get this really cool scene where all these boots come crashing down, and they're like, "Hold your crosses high for His Majesty Yhwach!" And it's like, what the hell? These guys are just so awesome. And they all salute him, and Yhwach comes across the front, in front of this big flag, and he's like, "So, Sternritters, are we all gathered? I have some information for you." Boom, chapter ends there. Now, there aren't actually any Sternritters present in this picture, which I thought was really weird. I presume they're off-screen. This promises a lot for next chapter. If you're a fan of the Quincy like I am, I'm expecting them to dominate the majority of the chapter. I particularly think we're probably going to get the Quincy version of, like, the Espada meeting around the table. But in typical Vandenreich fashion, it's going to be like some grand hall. But maybe we'll get confirmation of Asnot. I sincerely hope we get that next week. Oh my god, if he's still alive, I'm going to go crazy. Because that would just be amazing. But I cannot wait to see the rest of the Sternritter. Seriously, the potential for next chapter for me now is overwhelming. I might go crazy next chapter, if it's as good as I'm hoping it's going to be. But yeah, I loved it. The Vandenreich at the end, that was perfect. I kind of wish we'd known. I mean, like, what is Yhwach's information? The fact that they've secured Uryu, maybe? Maybe he knows Ichigo's got a new blade? Maybe he knows Ichigo's not technically in Seireite anyway anymore. I definitely think the announcement of a new invasion is going to come soon. I sincerely hope so, anyway. If the Vandenreich have as much Datan as they claim, they should know that all the remaining Soul Reapers are basically in training at the moment, so you think they'd go after them. But I am really excited for next week. Oh my god, so excited. Let me know what you think in the comments below. What do you think of this chapter? What do you think of Ichigo's new blades? Do you like them? Do you not like them? What do you think? How do you think he's going to fight with them? Do you like the idea of dual wielding? Put it in the comments below. Let me know. Also, check out my blog in the description below. You can follow it. You don't need an account. As far as predictions for next week, I've basically just said what I think is going to happen. I really think it's going to be a Sternritter meeting of sorts, where we get possibly even names for a lot of the ship, like the helmet Sternritter, the dude with the scar. I just think the Colonel Sanders Quincy, I think we'll hopefully get names for some of them. Hopefully people like Bambietta will have more lines. I just want to see the Sternritter more. They're so awesome. I want to see them more. And I sincerely hope that happens next week. People like Busby. I mean, obviously, he's still alive. God, I hope that's not still alive. Oh, man. Oh, he's literally going crazy in my video next week if that's not still alive. But yeah, that's kind of my predictions. That's what I think's going to happen. I don't know what Bark's information is for his people. Possibly another declaration. I hope so. That'd be awesome. But I do expect them to dominate the majority of the chapter. Panel of the week, it's kind of got to go to Ichigo with his blades. Although I don't like how basic he is. I mean, like, every other picture where Ichigo's got a new blade, there is at least some smoke. This time there's nothing. I think you could have at least had, like, some vapour coming off it, because obviously you just evaporated the water. But nevertheless, it's very striking, it's very powerful. And it's just interesting, because obviously you're looking at him from the back, he hasn't got any sleeves anymore, he looks awesome. But like I said, the swords themselves leave a little bit to be desired. So I also have to I also love the picture with the Quincy saluting Bark. That looks flipping awesome. So personally, for me, I'm going to go with that. I think it looks great. But also the picture with the swords. So, final verdict of the chapter. In fact, let's not do that yet. Let's do comment of the week. So, I've got a couple of comments from last week that I wanted to talk about. One of them is from Into FF7, and they say, I agree if Ichigo is going to spend some time training, it should then go back to the Vandenreich, which it appears it has done. Awesome. I really want Yhwach to send some back to the Soul Society to kill more captains. I think more should have died in the first invasion, not just one. Agreed. Byakuya should have gone, but, you know, that's past now. Maybe Uryu goes as a test of loyalty. Yes, I agree. Thank you for your comment. I'd love Uryu to go and fight. I think he should track down Mayuri and possibly even kill him. That would be awesome. Maybe revealing he now has Volstan Dish, or that's possibly a little bit too fast moving. But regardless, I so want that to happen, and I think it would be absolutely amazing. Thanks for your comment. I did have my other one chosen. Typically, I've now forgotten which one it was. Hold on a second. Oh yes, here we go, by Jordan Candelaria, says, do you think it's possible because of his hollow powers he will not just achieve Bankai, but a resurrection as well? It's not impossible, as Tozen had both, though I believe he would have two releases like Ulquiorra. So, yeah. What? What? Yes? So yeah, I definitely think that he could have a release form. But I think we've possibly already seen it, as far as his battle with Ulquiorra. I think that the horned Ichigo is about as close as a release form we're going to get to him. So, yeah, I don't know, we might not get a release form. I mean, I know he's totally accepted his hollow powers now, but, oh man, it's boiling. I don't think we're going to see a resurrection. He's obviously going to get Bankai, though, because that'd be stupid if he didn't. But, yeah, definitely going to get released from. So, awesome chapter. I want to give it a 10. Oh, but not much happened. But we did see new blades, and he does have dual wielding, and the Vandenreich were in it. 10 out of 10. I have to do it. And I think next chapter, as long as everything I want to happen happens, it's going to be a 10 out of 10 as well. So that's it for me for this week, guys. Give this video a thumbs up if you like what you see. Comment below. Also, check out my blog. Give it a follow and comment on that as well. And until next week, guys, catch you later.